Good afternoon, everyone. Today we celebrate the vigil of the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Governor Edwards has issued the mask mandate for all indoor gatherings in Louisiana, including church gatherings, in response to the latest outbreak of COVID. Please help us comply with this request by our governor. The special collection this weekend is for the Archdiocese Catholic Communications Campaign. Please use the envelopes marked My Offering in the pews. Please help our church proclaim the good news of Jesus in our world. We continue to remind you to please turn off or silence all electrical devices. This Mass is being offered for all of us and our families, and especially for Lawrence Arkell, William J. Rowden, Ned Cadella, James Swallow Sr., Clifford Brian Schmidt, Jack Colato, Lorraine Mary LeClaire, Judge Patrick Schott, Lorraine Sheehy Pendleton, Rose Walgamont, Matthew Isley, Elizabeth Shasheri Brennan, Mr. and Mrs. Anthony L. Zupardo, Anthony E. Zupardo, Mary Ross Barrage, Sean Patrick Griffin, Louis Gilbert Lafleur, Elizabeth Henry, Norma Allnut, Marco Tulio Samuel Bocanegra, Terrence Sloan, Robert Bridgewater, the successful surgery of Michael, the healing of Christy Linton, in memory of Sally Dewey, for special family intentions, and the intentions for Mark Capel and Ryan Curtis Baker. Our gathering hymn can be found in the red gather hymnal, number 593. Number 593, On Eagle's Wings. Let us all rise as we lift up our voices to the Lord.
Thank you. brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for the transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace, for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? It is not from your passions that make war within your members. You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask but do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. Have everyone back together as one community. It's great to be back in this holy house of God for Mass. It's great to have the kids back in school, and I know they're excited, and I know their parents are very excited to have them back at school. Children have such great desire to learn. They have complete trust in their parents and their teachers. Good teachers, they reflect the love of Christ. They teach the way he taught when they respond well. Ultimately, Jesus came to free us from our sin and to open the gates of heaven for eternal life for us. But Jesus also came to heal, to preach, and to teach. Today, Jesus and his disciples began a journey to Galilee. Jesus was teaching his disciples on this journey, and he wanted to have them alone so that he can reveal an intimate, profound truth to them. But before we look at what the specific truth is that Jesus wanted to reveal to them, it's important for us to look at the Gospel of Mark a little more closely. The first 8 chapters of the Gospel of Mark, there's this recurring theme of Jesus as a misunderstood Messiah. Mark repeatedly reveals Jesus as the Messiah, but those that he reveals Jesus to, they don't understand. When the disciples and Jesus are surrounded by so many people that they can't eat, the people who know Jesus, they say, "He's crazy, he's out of his mind." The Jewish authorities say, "He's possessed." No one recognizes that he's the Messiah, the Anointed One, the Savior of the world. When Jesus taught in the synagogue in his hometown, they said, "Isn't this the carpenter?" And they were offended at him. Their unbelief was so great that Jesus couldn't even work miracles there. Even the disciples, who knew, understood, and loved Jesus the most, failed to recognize him. When he calms a storm, they say, "Who is this? Even the wind and the sea obey him." Right after he performs the miracles of the loaves and the fish, they see him walk on water, but still they don't understand. Their hearts were hardened. But then in the 8th chapter of Gospel of Mark, there's a turning point. Jesus heals a blind man, but this healing is a little bit different than some other ones. It takes place in 2 stages. Jesus lays his hands on the blind man, and the blind man begins to see, but he sees men walking as trees. I'm sure he was quite surprised and confused by that. And then Jesus lays his hands on him again, and it says he sees clearly. Jesus persisted, and the man saw clearly. Similarly, the disciples don't understand, but Jesus persists. And in fact, in last week's gospel, they have a breakthrough. Last week's gospel, which occurred right after this blind man was healed, Jesus asked the disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And Peter says, "You are the Christ." So after this breakthrough in last week's gospel, why this lack of understanding today? I think for two reasons. The first, the truth that Jesus gave the disciples today, it was a difficult one. And it is a difficult one for us. Jesus says to them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." See, the Jewish tradition taught that the Messiah will be a political Messiah, a great, strong political leader that would lead his people out of oppression. So when Jesus predicts his death, the disciples are confused. And even more so, this saying about after 3 days, he will rise after being killed, this confused the disciples. In fact, this teaching is hard for us, the teaching of the cross. The idea that we share in the agony and the suffering and the self-sacrifice of the cross is confusing. But we know and we believe by faith that like Jesus, when we endure the cross in joy and patience, ultimately it gives abundant life here on earth and eternal life in heaven. Now, the second reason the disciples had this lapse in understanding was due to their hardness of heart or their pride. Jesus presents something that's profound and they don't understand. And how do they react? Instead of asking him to explain it, instead of humbling themselves and saying, "I don't understand," they begin to argue. They say, "Oh, I don't understand this, but I'm still surely the greatest of the disciples." So how does Jesus break through their lack of understanding, to break through their hardness of heart? He helps them recognize who he is by revealing to them who they are. He reveals to them who they are as children of God, with the child in his midst. In fact, St. Paul writes about this repeatedly. St. Paul writes to the Galatians, "For you are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus." To the Romans, "For all who are being led by the Spirit of God are sons of God." And to the Corinthians, "And I will be a father to you, and you will be sons and daughters to me, says the Lord Almighty." You see, humility, the solution to pride, is being fully aware of who we are as children of God. Be fully aware that he is the one that provides for us. Just like the child in today's gospel, God holds us in his loving arms. We recognize that as truly beloved sons and daughters of God, we begin to know Jesus through our relationship with him. And when we begin to know Jesus, it becomes possible for us to see the world through the eyes of our Savior. It becomes possible to accept the seemingly impossible cross. It becomes possible to become the first by being the last and the servant of others. When we recognize God's love for us first, then we can help spread the word and spread the love of God to others. So as we come together as one community to celebrate Mass today, we ask God to open the eyes of our hearts so that we may more fully understand and embrace the mystery of the cross, so that, like Jesus, we may offer ourselves to be the first by being the last and the servant of all.
Together we stand and confess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, and the Holy Spirit. we offer to the Lord the following prayers and petitions.
For healing and needed resources for all who suffered loss at Hurricane Ida, and that we might be instruments in the recovery, we pray to the Lord. For God's blessing and strengthening for energy workers, construction workers, and other essential personnel who will help in the storm recovery, we pray to the Lord. For God's blessings on the people of Cuba, Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan as they struggle to secure rights in the face of persecution and opposition, we pray to the Lord. For Pope Francis's prayer intention for the month of September, that we will all make courageous choices for a simple and environmentally sustainable lifestyle, rejoicing in our young people who are resolutely committed to this, we pray to the Lord. For God's blessing and healing of all victims of clergy sexual abuse, and for healing in our church, we pray to the Lord. That through the intercession of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, we may be spared the loss of life and property damage during this hurricane season, we pray to the Lord. For all who are sick, for God's healing grace, and for our deceased loved ones, including Naira L. Collins and Joe Hartman, who was a longtime usher at the 4 o'clock Mass here, we pray to the Lord. We now pause to add our own intentions in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Please join in saying our family prayer and the prayer to end coronavirus, which are on the prayer cards in the pews.
Loving and faithful God, we begin to the people of our sins, and we make the prayers of God to the people of our sins. We come to you, God, we are now, and as we are all set out today, and as we are all set out today, we implore you to be with us, and we implore you to be with us, and we implore you to be with us.
Lord Jesus, you travel through towns and villages, curing every disease and illness. Come to our aid in the midst of the coronavirus, where we experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick with the virus, and may we gain your strength and health. Bring those who have died from the virus to eternal peace. Protect doctors, nurses, and healthcare professionals as they help the sick. Allow the vaccine to be successful halting the spread of the virus. Be with leaders of nations. Give them wisdom to act with true concern for their people. Grant us peace in this time of uncertainty and challenge. Be this in your most holy name, Jesus, for you are a loving and healing Lord. Our Lady of Prompt Succor, St. Joseph, St. Francis Xavier, St. Rock, and St. Rosalie, pray for us.
Loving and faithful God, you are our rock and our salvation. We ask you to hear and answer these prayers according to your most loving plan, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Let us all sing together song number 513. Number 513. In the red gathered hymnal, number 513, I want to walk as a child of the light.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity may the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs and angels, we praise you and with joy we acclaim you. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith.
Jesus, God,
celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. As we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis the Savior, with all the saints, of whose constant intercession in your presence we rely on unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Gregory our Bishop, Cherie his assisting bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, have mercy on us.
Let us all sing together our communion song, number 661, number 661 in the Red Gather Hymnal, the Servant Song.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Quick announcement, you can be seated. Please take home a copy of this week's bulletin and check out the pictures and article about Hurricane Ida. 10 a.m., well, that's the 10 a.m. Mass only, but those are dead. Our bereavement groups for those grieving the loss of a loved one will meet at noon and 6:30 this Tuesday. All are invited. Our young adult ministry will have a meeting and a meal this Thursday at 6:30 p.m. in St. Joseph Hall. Contact me to sign up. The Old Metairie Golf Classic is still on for this Friday, but due to the hurricane's interruption, they're having trouble finding teams. They're most in need of players and donors and sponsors. So see our website to sign up for that, the Men's Club Golf Classic, this Friday. We'll do storm cleanup in heavily affected Lafitte, Louisiana, next Saturday. See the website for details and a link on the website to sign up for that. Our parish school of religion will begin next Sunday afternoon. Call the parish to sign up. The Chosen program showing in St. Joseph Hall will begin October 13th, and we schedule for four consecutive Wednesdays. See the flyers on the doors about information to sign up and to RSVP for a free meal for those nights. Sarah Jane McMahon concert is rescheduled for Sunday, October 17th at 3 p.m. in church to help us get the word out, because that's going to be a good time. And then finally, our Adoration Chapel will reopen at 7 a.m. on Monday with normal hours. So thanks to Dottie Watson and all our doors who will be present. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Saint Michael, the Archangel, be our protection and may God renew him the humbly prayer, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, let the power of God cast on the devil Satan. All evil spirits, who prowl down the world seeking humorous souls.
And as we go forth, let us all sing together song number 681 in the Red Gather Hymnal, number 681.